How do I change my telephone number on Google? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Honestly, I would guess that not having a phone number associated with your Google account or not keeping that phone number up to date might be the number one reason people lose access to their hacked Google account permanently. The bottom line from that, of course, is if you haven't set one now. And if you have set one, but it's out of date, change it now. That's what I'm going to show you how to do. Now, I've got to start by stating what to me at least is obvious, but a lot of folks don't understand that this is a requirement. You must be able to sign into the account. That's it. You have to be able to sign into the account to change any of the security information associated with the account. If you didn't have to sign in, well, then anybody could do it. And you certainly don't want that chaos. So signing into your account is your way of proving you are authorized to make these changes. If you can't sign into your account, you have to recover account access first before you change the phone number. And yes, I hear from many people who have lost access to their account. They no longer have access to the phone number currently associated with that account, and they want to change the phone number so that they can use that phone number to regain access. It's a chicken and egg problem. If you had access, you could change the phone number, but since you don't have access, you can't change the phone number. I really strongly recommend you pay attention to your recovery information in important accounts like this one. Now, I am going to throw up a quick caveat. Everything that I'm going to show you right now will be using the desktop browser version of Google accounts. I strongly recommend that you make important changes like that using a real computer or a laptop rather than a mobile device. The interface on a computer or laptop is clearer, and it may include options that just aren't available on mobile. So let's go change the number. Here you can see I am signed into a Google account. It is the askleotest@gmail.com account. We're going to click on Manage Your Google Account. Then we'll click on Personal Info here on the left-hand side, and then scroll down a little bit. There, in contact information, is a phone number. Great. This is the phone number we want to change. If this phone number is current and you have access to texts sent to this phone number, you really don't have to change it. You can. You may want to use a different phone number. That's great. But as long as you have access to this phone number, this isn't necessary. On the other hand, if you no longer have access to whatever this phone number is, absolutely you want to change it. So we will click on it. There's the phone number again. And we'll click on that to show it again, basically the phone number and how it might be used. The important thing to do here is to click on the pencil icon, because that then will allow you to change the phone number. Now, as you can see, I had to log in again. It had to prove that I was who I said I was. Since this is a security-sensitive change, you may be asked to prove your identity again, even if you're already signed in. So it brings up the Update Number dialog box, gives you some side effects of the potential of doing so, and we'll click on Update Number. And now we just get to enter a completely new phone number to do with whatever we will. So we'll change it just by typing in a new number. I'm going to use a completely different area code, different phone number, and click on Next. What happens now is that Google will want to send that phone number a text message with a verification code. This proves that you've entered the phone number correctly. It really is yours. And, well, it really is yours. It's a phone number you have access to, or the person who owns it has access to and has it with your permission. So we'll click on Get Code. It has now sent a code to that number. Assuming you have access to that number, enter the code that you got. In this case, it was G-375454. Now remember, these are random numbers. The fact that you can see what I'm typing in right now, honestly, means nothing. It gives you nothing. As soon as I hit verify, that code is no longer interesting. We'll hit verify. Boom. Okay, the number has been updated in my Google account. That's it. That's all you've done. You've changed your phone number on Google. Again, the single most important piece of advice I can give you is to make certain that this phone number is kept up to date. If you lose this phone number, not the phone, but the phone number, then you need to come back here and change it to the phone number that you now have. And remember, if you lose your phone, typically that number can be ported from your old lost phone to your new replacement phone. Google sends these messages to the phone number. Whatever device has that number is the device you need to have. If you don't have access to any device that responds to that number, you need to change the phone number in your Google account to whatever device you actually do have and are available to receive text messages. Hope that helps. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/174254. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.